And first of all, I can say on behalf of Consolo, thank you so much for coming this evening and sharing this very special moment with us. And I'd like to start by saying thank you to Anne Enright, who is responsible ultimately for this night. When I went to Anne about a year and a half ago with the concept of doing an anthology of short stories, she came on board straight away, and you've been a true friend of Consolo, and I want to thank you so much, Anne, for your dedication, your commitment to this project. And especially Sinead Gleeson, who's the editor, has, you know, it's been a labor of love for Sinead. She's worked tirelessly on this, with all the organizing, the planning, the preparation of the articles, of this, the short stories. Sinead, I want to thank you so much for that. I'd also like to thank Mark Gleeson for the design, and Ronnie Gleen, Darren Hughes, New Wild Publications, and all the authors who contributed to this anthology of short stories, in aid of Consolo. In Anne's powerful introduction of the book, she talks about connection, and she states in it, we are connected, we are not connected. And when you read her introduction, you'll understand where that really comes from. But it's at times like this that I'm reminded of the importance of making a connection. Sadly, through our work in Consolo, we know that so many people who die through suicide have in some way become disconnected, perhaps from their traditional supports, their families and friends, and even disconnected from life. By being here today, you have already made an important connection with Consolo, with bereaved families, and with others who care enough about suicide that you work around the clock to prevent the next terrible tragedy. Tonight is not the time really to speak, rather it is the time to listen. It is a time to hold the vital space, keeping faith and vigil with those who feel sick with shock, numb with grief, abandoned, desperate, alone. Consolation is precious. To console is to give comfort, refuge, protection, and love to those who are in pain. At Consolo, we have been doing just that for the last 10 years, helping put shattered lives back together, bearing witness to grief and pain, not just offering hope, but being the hope at the other end of the phone, at the other end of a life from which its owner has chosen, carefully or suddenly, to step out. Every year in Ireland, over 500 people do just that. At a particular moment, the greatest desire they have for and out of their life is to end it. Often we don't know why, but we do know the consequences. The empty chair at the table, the sound of the key in the door, the quick, heavy step up the path, the tubs of hair gel half used on the bathroom shelf, the signature scent on the landing, the dream of grandchildren are all no more. Instead, there's pain, torture, unending cruise to the heart, the mind and soul. And where there is Consolo. And I can identify with that pain and devastation because it's only a couple of years ago that my own sister Sharon, at the age of 21, died by suicide. And it came as a terrible shock to us as a family because we genuinely didn't see it coming. And we were left with the legacy of suicide, and that is the why. You know, why did she do it? You know, she was the baby in my family, and you know, we were asking, you know, was her love not enough? And if only we'd have known that she was in crisis, we would have moved to heaven and earth to prevent it, because she was deeply, deeply loved. And it was the element of choice, the fact that she chose to end her life, that made it even more difficult for us, that she had a little note saying goodbye to us all individually. And there were no clues at the end of the day. She was just saying sorry about what she was about to do. And that tremendous sense of failure I felt as our big brother, that I didn't, you know, that I didn't protect her, that I didn't save her, and that was nothing compared to what my mother and father felt, and the guilt they felt. You know, my mother used to say to Paul, how could we have missed this? I mean, how could we not see that she was in crisis? And to be honest with you, the impact it had on my family was devastating, because after a short period of time, I lost my mum and my dad, and I know it was because of Sharon's death. And it made me realize that death through suicide was a more protracted grief, a more complicated grief, because, as I said earlier, because of the element of choice, the Vatican no one chose to end his or her life. And that's why it was really truly out of that pain and devastation that I founded Console, because there was no help there 10 years ago for my family. And I remember at the time, you know, trying to get help from my mother, you know, get her counselling. And I brought her to a bereavement counsellor, but after a couple of visits to bereavement counsellor, said, Paul, I'm totally out of my depth here. I can't continue. So I suppose out of my own anger and frustration after Mum and Dad's death that I found the consoler. I started in my house in Selbridge, to be honest with you. I had an extra phone installed, and I used to say to my kids, if that phone rings, don't answer it. You know, and by God, they often did, and they were talking to Harry on the phone and all this sort of stuff. But then, and I realised very quickly, even at that point, that I was out of my depth because I was getting very harrowing calls from people who were on the brink of ending their lives, and then I had to go and get help and support from professionals to establish the service. And what we have today is now, Console is a national, I'm making it sound very easy, I'm jumping very fast here, because when I went to the Department of Health and Children looking for support for this project, I was initially shown the door, to be honest with you. There was no appetite for establishing a dedicated service to those bereaved through suicide. But anyhow, I went ahead, I was determined, and I think it was out of my own grief, my own pain, my own loss and devastation. I didn't go for therapy. I think I worked my channel, my energies into this. I was determined to do it. And basically what we have today is now a national service for those suicide prevention service and bereavement service for those in suicidal crisis and those who are bereaved through suicide. And we offer one-to-one counselling, family therapy, group therapy, child psychotherapy service for children and adolescents who are in crisis. And we also have our... we've gone as far as having a diploma in suicide studies out in UCD as well, the academic side of it. I mean, we have a tremendous team in our service working 24 hours a day, and we've got a 24-hour helpline for those who are at risk of suicide. It's different to the Samaritans because it's not a listening service. They're qualified, accredited therapists and clinicians working 24 hours a day around the clock, dealing with people who are on the brink of ending their lives. And it's a lifeline to many people. And so that's a very important piece of our work at Console. At the end of the day, we couldn't do it. I mean, I have to raise 1.5 million a year to keep the service going. It's a big challenge for me. I wake at night, I've got an amazing wife who puts up with it. I mean, but anyhow, Anne Enright has been a tremendous support from, you know, she's been there for us. Has always been a great support to Console, and of course, I want to thank you, Anne, for your great support. And you know what I'm talking about. You've been there for me, and I want to thank you so much for your help. And Sinead, you know, when I met you, you were fantastic how you came on board as well. You know, with this big project, this massive task, and I want to thank you so much for that. And finally, because I'm going on too long now. Sorry about this. And finally, I'm sure you've heard the phrase that you're never alone without a book. It's a phrase that came to mind when I first discussed the project with Anne Enright. This is because Console's role in suicide prevention is also much rooted in trying to convince people in crisis that they too are not alone, that there is help. And as the title of the book says, Silver Threads of Hope. And that life is worth living. I want to thank you so much on behalf of Console. And before I go, there's two people I have to thank. There's Sister Marguerite Buckley, who is one of our counselling, senior counselling team, and Eddie and Colette Linsky from our centre in the Navan Road. Thank you so much for your commitment to Console. Thank you so much, Sister.